experience of 30 years in this industry. I started LED in 1985. I did so many projects, products, and not any components. I was Sita told. We should do that. In this scenario, what happened? The small diversion, of course, to the Indian industry in three sectors. You know very well. One is we are making waves, ISRO, that is a space technology, going beyond the world. Other one is the automatic, Bob Atomic Research Center, which we are making waves in the globe. And centered from Bangalore and Bombay. And what happened to the electronics? Controlled from Delhi. It was there properly, but it was not grown as per the world standards like space technology and atomic energy technology. But we're good at software, and even we changed the name in between. Department of Electronics became Department of IT. Again, thanks back, they realized electronics is so important. They made it IT, and they're making waves there, giving a lot of incentives by MCIPs. In that, one of the star is LED product, which has got a lot of potential as per their plans. This is our most $34 billion market, which we are addressing. But India, we are good at individual working, we are good at products, but we are not good at core R&D like components. We miserably failed, I should say, in component industry because of a lot of issues. But fortunately, I always think positive thinking. If we get problems, definitely we will get advantage of learning experience, which that experience can be passed to so many people and to the next generation. Now, the opportunity we got again in electronics, the best opportunity is LED. If you take a few seconds or 1 or 2 minutes, what we are doing with LEDs, are we living without LED? If you start from the morning, we'll wake up and start by the office, switch on the car, dashboard is backlight is LED, switch on the phone, SMS are backlighting LED. We go to office, lighting is LED, signal lamps are LED, and of course, automobile indicators are LED. They are coming back, street lights are LED, and while sleeping also, bedlight is LED. We go to flight, reading light, lamp is LED, and in the ships also LED. Everywhere LED, LED, LED. So, I should say proudly again, as I told Bangalore and Bombay, where electronics neglected in Delhi, again that opportunity came through IT, huge listings. Now, LED focus, the credit goes to the Narendra Modi ji, Piyush Goyal ji, and ESL MD Saurabh Kumar ji. Huge opportunity they have given. We should thank them with a big applause to start this presentation. In the scenario of struggling industry, they gave opportunity, but at the same time, a lot of issues they are facing. They are supporting us. They are very proactive way. Like so many issues we have, we don't have proper infrastructure and we don't have proper, power sources and all. Still we are getting a lot of, products which we can sell in the globe. So as I told you, we are good at product, not at overall ecosystem. In my thing, the products have become a global, but we are not having any total ecosystem. No more protection for domestic production even in Indian market. International competition is we are facing. The contest of electronics, hardware and software, we won in global attention, and also now hardware as a second sunrise we are focusing. And as I told you, lacking a lot of component base, as Sita suggested, someone can come up in a massive way to do in component industry, especially LED or any other components related to this industry. Activities, as you know very well, the production means in India, in my view, even LED streetlights or whatever it is, whatever technology. We should accept the fact. But we are going towards automation because of volumes. We are going towards a quality consciousness because we are competing globally and we are supplying our products in a very bad environment. Then the design should be very good and production quantities also should be good. Making global products calls for global level investment for R&D. People are ready to do that. The economic scales are very limited, but because of the country what we are living in, because the local opportunity we are having, we have a huge scale in LED industry, in lighting especially. And we do supply a lot of screens. I used to export, almost exported 250 screens to US universities. And you might be knowing Jengura, Kingdom of Dreams, we are proud, that is our product. Recent in elections, 3D LED based hologram we supplied for the Narendra Modi ji's and Andhra Pradesh elections. Similarly, lot of applications, everything in products, but they're not in component. But you have to focus total ecosystem, that is my crash. Manufacturing is not product manufacturing, total ecosystem should come. And if you don't get, opportunity of selling the total product, at least we can sell the components to all the people. Suppose you are not able to compete the ESL tenders, you do the component, due to the packaging, you can supply to everyone. Now at present, everything is going to China or Korea or Taiwan. And I'm surprised to see recently, I think last month, in China, one of the exhibitions they are selling ESL driver made for Indian ESL tender. So ESL become that popular. Same time, I was so happy to see ESL there, but at the same time, I'm guilty to see that. Why can't you do that one in India? Unless we are good at component based industry growth, we cannot grow in future. Of course, whatever we did, it is what we have. We did a good job, but now it is time to go for component industry also. Players like Bosram, Philips, and Cyclogis, Havels, and big players, at least they should start packaging in India. They will be having a problem. Yeah, as you know, the Prime Minister's Make in India slogan, sell globally, as we suggested. I am very, very confidently can say our product quality is fantastic. Same ESL bulb or ESL street light, I think we can sell anywhere in the globe, including South America, at a better price than compared to Chinese. Because of this volume, we can add the volumes. I think the people are coming for volumes only ESL. They are aggressively going price down. Parallelly, they can export. This opportunity, like Chinese, what they did, local consumption, then export. So you can get the trials if you over, you need not get much margins in this. But in future, you can get good margins by exporting, going for value addition in the systems. As I mentioned, in the LED light only if you take, we have so many systems like power electronics, mechanical thermal management. When some people are going towards thermal plastics, they're not using metal for street lights also up to 100 watt. Already proven technology is available, where we can have a very mass production and we can supply intelligent lights, because we are very good at software and embedded technologies. We can do intelligent lights, like different applications, air growing LEDs are coming, plant growing LEDs are coming, face mask LEDs are coming, and also D vitamin improvement LEDs are coming. Even very recently, if you go to mall, LED light can communicate to you with your iPhone or any phone. You can receive the data from them, like a reverse of remote. It can send the information, local information, or a street light can be very, very intelligent street light. It can pass the information of surrounding, environment details, and also it can send the information to your phones, to the nearby. You need not have any bandwidth or Wi-Fi, etc. So that much growth has come in LED technology that we can concentrate, because they are good at embedded software and software systems. And material science, we should focus. A lot of funds are available from the government of India organizations, where we can take for R&D. A lot of institutions are there. We are being a product companies in India, more R&D should go to material science and component technology with our strengths of embedded technology and software. And some of the points, suggestions, or maybe my views, I mean, success of these bulbs or street lights will depend on, of course, bulbs no problem because it is an indoor. Street lights success depends on present infrastructure conditions, everyone knows. I used to tell the people, see, for example, without proper acting we are running, still it is working, means our product is very good, no doubt. But I compare acting as a seatbelt. So running without seatbelt is a very high speed. But people say we have a protection system like airbags. Airbag is there, but seatbelt is not there. So we have to get a proper, I mean, sufficient infrastructure also. My request to the municipal commissioners and municipal authorities to give the proper infrastructure for the Indian industry to support ESL and manufacturers to have a better, street lights and to have a better product to the your municipality and better implementation, because we are supposed to give 7 years warranty. Similarly, one more suggestion from my side. In some of the towns or side roads, we are giving 15 watt to 20 watt, even 12 watt to 15 watt street lights. In my view, fundamental knowledge, whatever we have the technology at the time, 40 watt tube light or any CFL, they use as a street lights. Because there was no technology, cheap technology available, they used that. That's why they are doing 40 watt tube light equivalent lux. Not that they won't deserve more light. Suppose if you recently shot in Vijayawada, it is like a moon, full moon light. Vijayawada is glowing like full moon light. But in villages, the lighting levels are not that great. I request to ESL and other authorities also, somewhere you can cut, you need not have 140 watt, 120 watt may be okay, even because of the efficiency is more. Minimum street light level for, minimum let it be 20 watt or even little better with a more focus on lux. 20 watt should have a minimum more than 100, lumens per watt as a system level. If you put that condition, 20 watt above 100 lumens per watt, the sufficient light, the poor people also will have a light at the same price, I think. That second point I want to request the concerned authorities. And urging government to encourage indigenous manufacturing of LEDs, as I mentioned. We are also trying to set up a very big unit for packaging. And first, then we'll go for MOCVD and other stuff. And also, we want to focus much in high-end technologies like image writing, hologram. I'm very proud, I'm tying up China. They're taking from me the hologram technology, 3D hologram technology. And similarly, my focus is other than this, two more technologies that already we did. You'll be surprised. Home theaters. Real LED TVs will be used for home theaters. Already we did with a 0.8 by 0.8 mm chip with a 1.2 mm pitch. The home theater screen of 144 inch. But little costly at present, it will be damn good for a high-end technology, that one. And similarly, smart cities are coming. Entire smart city, we need control. Control applications, at present they are using so many TVs or back projection systems, and they are putting so many pieces to have one control display. Whereas with LED, with a pitch of 1.6 or 1.9 mm, we are giving a control room, huge control room, or a power plant or any other process plant or even the total entire smart city control room today. Like that, Indian industry can grow, not only in lighting, where city are good at, we can apply that one to the LED applications. Even one of the industries can grow, new people can come from the colleges, we can take a guidance, we can give from our LATMA, and definitely we can give some technology transfer also. For example, D vitamin. So many people are not able to see the sun. Surya Namaskar we do, but we don't get a chance to do that. But we'll give in the house, in the bathroom, or one of the rooms, or reading rooms, we'll give D vitamin with a maybe 1000 watt light. And one more thing I'm very proud to say, and shooting lights also we did. 4000 watt Osram, my friend is here, replaced with 960 watt LED, which is giving very wonderful light. They're using for shooting applications. So there are so many opportunities. So one big opportunity is lighting, fine. But you focus on other things also. Let us have a good product companies supported by total ecosystem, the component industry, and go global. And thank you very much for this opportunity.